What's up, guys? It's Sight After Dark out of Brooklyn, New York. I'm Sifa Graffiti.
I'm Dan Berg.
Today we are reacting to Who Are the Brain Police by the Mothers of Invention. I wonder who's in this band. Anyway, this was suggested by one of our patrons, special person. Shout out to you. You know who you are. Thumbs up if you like this one, guys.
Say about this one.
Go for it.
That was so wild, because I mean that was like a metal song, and this is his first album. I know for sure. I don't know what year. I think it's like 66, so that's mad ahead of its time. Like the first Black Sabbath album was like 71.
Oh yeah,
so this is like 5 years before Black Sabbath. Mm-hmm. That's wild.
And before Zeppelin too.
Yeah, no, I had no idea. Like, this was, wow, I'm really blown away by how old this is and how metal this is. This must have been like an influence on metal that I didn't even really know about.
Right.
Because this is like, those guitars were so heavy from the first note. Boom! It sounded like the beginning of Iron Man almost. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
And then even that hum, like, that's literally sounds like it could have been in an Alice in Chains song.
Oh yeah, for sure.
You know what I mean? That's crazy. This is 66. I'm just going to say 66, like I'm sure that it is. I'm not really sure, but I'm going to say it's 66. That's crazy. I'm freaking out.
Yep. loved it. And also, I said to myself, like, if I were able to hear this, and this is the first I've heard of this music, like, if I was one of the first people to hear this, like, it would have been amazing for me, like, mind-blowing. You want to think of the music of the 60s, and you want to think of this. This would have been totally up my alley, especially in a place like New York in the 1960s. Like, this would have been, like, great, because it's very, it's thought-provoking, which is funny, because it's like, who are the brain police? In that way where, let's say, in the mid to late 60s, there are a lot of philosophies, theories, you know, people breaking out in alternate religions, people breaking out into alternate forms of consciousness, segregation, women's rights, this, that. So, you know, if you were any type of progressive kind of person, you probably saw people that were, you know, more along a 50s, 40s type of thinking as, like, not that bright. And if you saw them as not progressing with you, you probably did ask a question like, who are the brain police? You know, and then I think he was kind of making fun of people that go on trips, like, you know, with the drugs and stuff, you know, with the, I think I'm going to die. I think I've heard that many times from people who, like, first time smoke pot, or like they take an ecstasy or something like that, and they take mushrooms, and they stand around there thinking like they're going to die, and you're looking at them like,
yeah, 100%.
You're an idiot. So, I've definitely done that to people, like, you know, in my mind, not while they're tripping. Who wants to do that to somebody while they're tripping? But in my mind, I've said to myself, you're an idiot. So, I'm with you, Frank, I guess.
Yeah, if I heard this back in the day, I would have just been filled with, like, paranoia. I would, because nothing sounded like this is, must have been the most metal, like, metal wasn't a thing yet. This must have been the most metal sounding thing out there. So first of all, it would have came on, I would have been like, oh my god. And then they would be all in my head, like, who are the brain police? I'm like, fuck, who are the brain police? Are they following me? You know, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
But it's just clear that Frank is just always, he's always just against censorship of any form and really control. Mm-hmm. Like, that seems to be something that's pretty clear consistently throughout all his different kinds of music. Mm-hmm. Is he's always calling people out that are trying to control their people or trying to make people think certain things or trying to affect the way that you think, when he is just on an intellectual level where he's just like, I just want to do what I want to do. This could have been about the people trying to put the labels on the albums.
It's possible.
I know this is way before. But this song relates to them.
Yeah, it definitely does. This is the type of song and vocalization that I would hear in an abstract play in New York. Like, and I could see that happening.
They're throwing paint at the walls and shit.
Yeah, I can even see it happening in a play in New York at this time. You go downtown and you watch some off-Broadway stuff. And
they're just,
you
like,
know,
doing, like,
and then the weirdest things with music. Yeah, because they want their soundtrack to sound anti-music, right? You want it to sound like something nobody's heard before. So I could easily see this happening. I could see this song. I could see how this was creatively made. Like, you know what I mean? Just a bunch of artists sitting around and stuff like that and really trying to go against the grain. So I'm into it.
Yeah, and something I wanted to say on your point earlier, I feel like if they were, like, talking about, like, the 40s, 50s thinking, I don't think they would necessarily look at that like, oh, these people are dumb, but they would look at them like they don't understand.
Right.
Or like they're just trying to keep us from doing what we know is right.
Right.
But I don't think they were like, oh, you're stupid.
Right.
You know what I mean?
Yeah, definitely not unintelligent, but how could you not see it?
Just like, come on, you don't get it.
Yeah, exactly.
You just don't get it.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? It's just, ah, man, what a time.
Yeah.
And it's just so crazy. This is the first album. It's like Frank came out swinging.
Definitely,
you know what I mean?
Did.
And he just
did.
Was swinging till the end.
Yeah.
Like, he never stopped. He really just kept going. So just, you know, like we say in, like, all of our Frank videos at this point, we just, our respect for him grows and grows with, like, every song. So shout out to our patron that suggested this. You know who you are. We appreciate you. Shout out to everyone on Patreon, everyone on YouTube. You're the best. We're S.A.D After Dark. Definitely listen to our music if you haven't already. And we'll see you soon.